Summary of Eat to Live, the Amazing Nutrient-Rich Program for Fast and Sustainable Weight Loss by Abbey Beathan Publishing, narrated by Cayla Taylor. Legal and disclaimer. The information contained in this book is not designed to replace or take the place of any form of medicine or professional medical advice. The information in this book has been provided for educational and entertainment purposes only. The information contained in this book has been compiled from sources deemed reliable and it is accurate to the best of the author's knowledge. However, the author cannot guarantee its accuracy and validity and cannot be held liable for any errors or omissions. Changes are periodically made to this book. You must consult your doctor or get professional medical advice before using any of the suggested remedies, techniques, or information in this book. Images used in this book are not the same as of that of the actual book. This is a totally separate and different entity from that of the original book titled Eat to Live. Upon using the information contained in this book, you agree to hold harmless the author from and against any damages, costs, and expenses, including any legal fees potentially resulting from the application of any of the information provided by this guide. This disclaimer applies to any damages or injury caused by the use and application, whether directly or indirectly, of any advice or information presented, whether for breach of contract, tort, negligence, personal injury, criminal intent, or under any other cause of action. You agree to accept all risks of using the information presented inside this book. You need to consult a professional medical practitioner in order to ensure you are both able and healthy enough to participate in this program. Forward. Weight gain occurs when energy intake exceeds energy expended, and conversely, weight losses occur when energy expended exceeds energy intake. At the extremes, both overweight and underweight present health risks. This book emphasizes overweight partly because it has been more intensively studied and partly because it is a widespread health problem in developed countries and a growing concern in developing countries. Despite our preoccupation with body image and weight loss, the prevalence of overweight and obesity in the United States continues to rise dramatically. In the past decade, obesity increased in every state, in both genders, and across all ages, races, and educational levels. Obesity is so widespread and its prevalence is rising so rapidly that many refer to it as an epidemic. Large segments of society place such enormous value on thinness that obese people face discrimination and prejudice everywhere. Feelings of rejection, shame, or depression are common among obese people. People attach so many dreams of happiness to weight loss that they are willing to risk huge sums of money for the slightest chance of success. Some interventions entail greater dangers than the risk of being overweight. An estimated 300,000 people die each year from obesity-related diseases. In fact, obesity is second only to smoking in causing preventable illnesses and premature deaths. Some of the nation's most popular diet books and weight loss programs have misled consumers with unsubstantiated claims and deceptive testimonials. Furthermore, they fail to provide an assessment of the short and long-term results of their treatment plans, even though such evaluations are possible and would permit consumers to make informed decisions. Of course, some weight loss programs are better than others in terms of cost, approach, and customer satisfaction, but few are particularly successful in helping people keep losing weight. With Dr. Joel Fuhrman's book, Eat to Live, readers can expect a reputable program that explains the risks associated with weight loss programs and provides honest predictions of success. This nutrition intervention is evidence-based, that is, they are based on scientific rationale and supported by the results of high-quality research. Doctors who have used it with their patients swear that the diet and health recommendations given by Dr. Fuhrman in this book praised variety as a valuable way to ensure an adequate intake of nutrients through healthier meal plans. In addition, it has been backed up by years of sound research that can provide long-term changes in a typical American lifestyle that will support weight maintenance or health goals. Mehmet C. Oz, MD, Director, Cardiovascular Institute, Columbia Presbyterian Medical Center. Introduction. Miss Rosalie was a new patient whose initial body weight was 215 pounds and was taking medications to control her diabetes and high blood pressure. Disappointed by the fact that her effort to lose weight has come to no avail, she tried Dr. Fuhrman's weight loss plan with a healthy dose of skepticism. Many people assume that every obese person can achieve slenderness and should pursue that goal. First, consider that most obese people cannot, for whatever reason, successfully lose weight and maintain their losses. Reducing their food intake further would jeopardize health and incur nutrient deficiencies. A plan was created for her to have an ideal weight of 125 pounds, which provides an adequate intake of nutrients from a variety of food sources. This supports a healthier and more successful weight loss than a restrictive plan that creates feelings of starvation and deprivation, which can lead to an irresistible urge to binge. After a month of following the weight loss plan, Miss Rosalie returned 20 pounds less than when she first came, and has not been on her diabetes and high blood pressure medications for 2 weeks. Year after year, new and improved diets appear on bookstore shelves and circulate among friends. People of all sizes eagerly try the best diet on the market, hoping that this will really work. Sometimes fad diets seem to work for a while, but more often than not, their success is short-lived. One that has fallen victim of these scams was Miss Rosalie, and so this book was designed in order to help people like her embrace clean eating. No matter what their names are, most fad diets espouse essentially the same high-protein, low-carbohydrate diet. If high-protein diets were as successful as some people claim, then consumers who tried them would lose lots of weight and our obesity problems would be solved. Obviously, this is not the case. Studies report that people following this diet do lose weight, but in the long run result in life-threatening diseases such as cancer. Richard Gross followed this diet plan and was reaping the benefits. Beforehand, he had angioplasty and bypass surgery. He was to undergo another procedure because a complication arose from his previous operation. He was motivated to find another solution, one that does not involve going under the knife. After 2 months, he brought his blood pressure and cholesterol level back to normal. All the while his chest pains were gone and his 6 medications too. 7 years have passed and still has shown no signs of vascular insufficiency. Cardiac patients who followed the formula covered in this book have proven to be reliable and sustainable methods to prevent even the most severe cases of heart disease brought about by obesity.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.